Let us pray.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this morning for bringing us here once again into your presence. We thank you for the night that has passed, and thank you for blessing us throughout the night and showing us another beautiful day. We thank you for your goodness. We are not deserving, but you are so good to us every day. We thank you. Thank you for your protection of our lives. Father, we thank you for this morning devotion program that you yourself has created for us. We thank you for all the nourishments that we obtain from this platform. We lift this platform up to you. We invite you. We invite the Holy Spirit. We ask you to be present at this breakfast table. We know you are present because you said where two or three people are gathered in your name, there you are. So we know that you are present here today. We pray today that you fill us with your Holy Spirit, inspire us today, open up our eyes of understanding today, so that we not only hear the words that are ministered to us today, but we have them be part of our lives, that we use them every day in our lives. We thank you. Accept our prayers today, accept our praises today, and let your glory be manifested in everyone's lives today. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Hello, good morning once again to the Morning Devotion platform. You're all welcome. We shall now go into our time of worship.
To Jesus, I surrender.
the joy of thy salvation.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation.
Renew a right spirit within me.
And renew a right spirit within me.
Create in me a clean heart. Oh, God.
Sing it to Jesus. Worship. Create in me a clean heart.
Create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from thy presence.
Cast me not away from thy presence, oh Lord.
Take not thy Holy Spirit.
Amen. We thank God for that beautiful time of worship. He's so worthy to be praised. We shall now go into our general prayers. And this morning, our general prayers will be led by Sister Ajibike. Let us please welcome and receive her.
Good morning. Today, we're praying for our pastor. Please mention your pastor by name as you pray. Father, our first prayer, thank you for today and for the pastor you have set over me. Please mention your pastor's name. Thank you for your hand upon my pastor in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Those in leadership are gifts from God. And I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Lord, I thank you for my pastor, Pastor Gundele, whom you have placed in the local body to keep us from being tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, speaking the truth in love. Let us grow up in you, Lord, in all things, for you are the head of the body. Bless Pastor Gundele, Lord, that he might govern your church according to your will. Help him to be a shepherd who never scatters the sheep, but who cares for the flock, who watches for their souls and seek those who are lost. Thank you, Lord, for wanting my pastor, Pastor Gundele, to be happy. You love him to bless your people, and you have surely blessed him. Thank you for showing him the way of blessedness in his life. Deliver him from the kingdom of self and clothe him with humility. The meek are happy because they will inherit the earth. Help my pastor, Pastor Gule, to become meek. The merciful are happy because they have obtained mercy. Make my pastor merciful, Lord. Second prayer. Father, I commit my pastor into your hands. Be merciful unto him. And I ask that you take away his judgments and cast off his enemies, that he sees evil no more. Let us pray. The Lord had taken away thy judgments. He had cast out the enemy, the king of Israel. Even the Lord is in the midst of thee. Thou shalt not see evil anymore. Help me to be a support to my pastor, to be available when he needs me, to be always willing to help him and to pray for him. As Aaron and Hur uphold the arms of Moses in the heat of the battle, so may I ever uphold the arms of those who you have appointed to lead me. Fill my pastor with knowledge of your will in all wisdom and understanding. Let him walk worthy of you, Lord, pleasing you by being fruitful in every good works and increasing in the knowledge of you daily. Let my pastor be strengthened with all might according to all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness. Multiply your grace and peace unto my pastor through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Prayer number three. Father, hide not thy face from my pastor, but stand by him and strengthen him and pour out your spirit upon him, that special miracle will be done by his hands. Let us pray. Neither will I hide my face anymore from them, for I have poured out my spirit upon the house of Israel, saith the Lord God. Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, that by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all the Gentiles might hear, and I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. Pastor Gundile can do all things through Christ who strengthens him. You are his strength and his shield, O Lord. You are his saving strength. When he walks in you, he walks in strength. Your grace is all he needs. Your wonderful strength is made perfect in his weakness. When he is weak, help him to remember to proclaim you, Lord, as strong. Thank you for always being there to stand by my pastor, Pastor Gundile. You are always ready to strengthen him. I receive your strength now to help him in specific weaknesses. Pastor Gundile has been strengthened with all might according to your glorious power unto all patience and all suffering with joyfulness. Because of the strength that you have imparted to my pastor, Lord, I give thanks to you and I depend totally on you. You are the vine and he is the branch. We pray in Jesus' name.
Good.
On every side, thou hast blessed the work of his hand, and his substance is increased in the land. The shield of faith quenches all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Lord God Almighty, we commit to your care and safekeeping. Pastor Gundile, may your ministry angels watch over him. Assign a guardian angel to Pastor Gundile, Lord, so that no evil will befall him. Protect him from the evil one. I lift up Pastor Gundile to you, and I ask you to watch over him like a mother hen watches over her chicks, and a shepherd watches over his sheep. Cover him with your feathers so that under your wings he will safely trust. Let your truth become his shield and buckler, so that he will not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the destruction that wastes at noonday. Bless him with the knowledge of your presence. You will be with him in trouble. You will deliver him and honor him. Satisfy him with long life, and show him your salvation. You said, Lord, that you will be a wall of fire around about Pastor Gundile, and you'll be glory in the midst of him. Praise your name. Bless the work of his hand, and his substance is increased in the land. Amen. Father, we thank you, Almighty God. We worship you. We adore you. Thank you, Lord, for always hearing our prayer. Multiply your grace and peace unto my pastor through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. May he be esteemed by you because he has humble and contrite heart and trembles at your word. We worship you, Almighty God. Blessed be your holy name. We lift up holy hands. You always hear us. Let our pastor be strengthened. Mention your pastor by name. Let your pastor be strengthened with all might according to all patience and long suffering with joyfulness. We have prayed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the living God.
Amen. 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 We thank God for answers to our prayers for our pastors today. We shall now go into our Bible reading. The words that I've spoken to you are spirit and life, says the Lord. So we shall make way for hearing his word this morning. And this morning's Bible reading is taken from John chapter 15, verses 6 to 17. John chapter 15. Verses 6 to 17. And this morning, our sister Lola Aromo Laran will be reading for us. Let us kindly welcome and receive her.
Good morning. I'm reading this morning from New King James Version. Thank you for the opportunity to read the Word of God this morning. John 15, 6 to 17. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be healed, to be made well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up, but while I'm coming,
yes. It's John 15, verses 6 to 17.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm reading John 5. Jeez. I'm so sorry.
No, no worries. No problem.
Okay. Sorry. 15.
6 to 17.
If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done to you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciple. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friend. You are my friends if you do whatever I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends, for all things that I heard from my Father I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give to you. These things I command you, that you love one another. May God bless the reading of his word. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. We thank God for, we thank you, Sister Lola, for reading the word for us. It is now time for the charge to be brought to us this morning. And this morning, the charge will be brought from one of our own, Sister Winifred. Let us kindly receive and welcome her.
Good morning. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your instructions unto us. May we always be doers of your words and not just hearers. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Adeyinka, for giving me this opportunity to bring the charge this morning. It's a privilege, and I do not take it for granted. Thank you for all your teachings, so we can continue to grow spiritually. Today's message is not new, as we have heard from my predecessors on the teachings of the series of the Fruit of the Kingdom Souls. All I'm going to be doing today is to analyze the Word of God as seen in the book of John 15, 1 to 5. We thank God for grace, because our God is not just a God of second chance, but God of unlimited chances. We all know Jesus was always speaking in parables, and those whose hearts were hardened, that were rejecting him, could not see, hear, or understand him because of the condition of their hearts. What is the condition of your heart? Now, let's take a look at the significance of the vine. And I want you today to visualize yourself as one of the branches on the tree attached to the vine. You know that tree, that vine, is your source of life, and you need it for growth and sustenance. You know you need to stay connected in order to survive. Without that true vine, you can do nothing and you perish. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee, oh, bless me now, my Savior, Lord. I come to thee. The word of God, John 15, 1 to 5. I am the true vine and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit. While every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. We have been called to bear fruits, as John concluded in his word. I appointed you to go and bear fruits, fruits that will last. Example of the similarity of fruitfulness is seen in the book of Psalm 128, as a wife is like a fruitful vine, and the children will be like olive shoots. So we keep stretching out, reproducing more and more, and more and more branches. That is what is expected of us, to keep adding more people to the kingdom of God. As children of God, we have been found and rebirthed. Now it is our turn to bring more people to Christ, to be rebirthed, born again. Verse 3 says, you are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I also remain in you. We were once seeds, little tiny seeds. Now we are grown, branches attached to the vine, where we are spiritually fed. I am the vine and you are the branches. We, the branches, are attached to this vine, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The vine that is strongly rooted, that can never be uprooted. He is our source of life, our strength, the nutrients to our souls, and everlasting life. As long as we stay connected to this vine, no one can pluck us away from him. And we grow to become more like him daily. Now we have been called to introduce that vine unto men so they too can have the food of life, to be nourished, enriched, and to have everlasting life. This is the Great Commission. Our assignment is to keep adding to the kingdom of God so they eventually become branches as well. That is the cycle of bearing fruits. But wait a minute. What kind of fruits are you bearing? The Bible says we shall know them by their fruits. Well, with the branches, when we are well nourished, spiritually fed by the power of the Holy Spirit, we start to bear the fruits of the Spirit, the fruits of the Holy Spirit, as seen in Galatians 5, 22 to 23. It says, but the fruits of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are the fruits of the Spirit in the kingdom souls. From that reading in John 15, we see that this process of bearing fruits cannot be done in our own strength. We must rely on the help of the Holy Spirit. Pray always and stay connected to that vine for empowerment. If I may borrow from that cliche, action speaks louder and better than voice. Our obedience is in the doing. Even if we study and know the words, abiding in the word like our Lord Jesus Christ, the vine, is more important. We cannot be confessing Christ with the mere words of our mouth, and our lifestyle is contradictory to his ways. Hence it says, no branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine, remain in me, and I in you. Now here is the warning. Please, here is the warning. Every branch that does not bear fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Let's take a look at this analogy. You have a big tree in your yard, It beautifies your compound. The branches are strong, provides ample shade that blows you cool breeze. You are always under that tree relaxing, perhaps eating fruits from the tree. All because that tree, that vine, is solid and well-rooted in the soil, so it feeds you. But wait a minute again. Immediately you notice that some of the branches are not that strong and they are getting weaker and weaker. They become dangerous, hazardous. So what do? You cut them down. You cut them off because they are useless, unable to produce leaves and fruits. Likewise, we need to be strong, useful branches, producing fruits of the Spirit. As long as we stay connected to that vine, it sustains us. It feeds us, gaining daily strength from our Lord Jesus Christ. Then we can fulfill our purpose as Christ ambassadors. May we never be like that useless branch that is cut off and thrown into the fire. As a result of bearing fruit, blessings come along. You are blessed, as seen in the book of Psalms. Psalm 1:3 says, they are like trees planted along the river banks, bearing fruits each season. Their leaves never wither, and they prosper in all they do. Let's take a look at Psalm 92. It says, they shall bear fruits in old age. They shall be fresh and flourishing, to declare that the Lord is upright. May God give you the grace for his calling unto stewardship, especially in witnessing, winning souls. And as you abide in him, he will surely open a book of remembrance for you. For his word says, test me in these and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessings that you will not have room enough for it. Let us go now and be strong branches, spreading the good news, adding to the kingdom of God, living the fruits of the Spirit. Start by planting them. Plant them on this morning devotion. Make sure they are walking the walk as they are spiritually fed. I now conclude with one of my readings, which says the life of the branch is created from the tree. The vine and the new life of the kingdom now flows out of this branch so as to bear and produce the fruit of this Holy Spirit. By so doing, we are confessing Christ because we have been transformed, regenerated, and we thank God, our Heavenly Father. Let us pray, please. Thank you, Father, for choosing us and calling us. We need you because you are doing the work in us. According to your word in Psalm 119, help us to continue to meditate on your precepts, contemplate your ways, to be delighted in your statutes, and never, never forget your word, but abide in you always. Amen. And thank you for joining this morning.
Amen. Amen. We thank God for that wonderful word that has been brought to us this morning to make sure that our branches are strong and rooted in the vine and are completely attached to the vine. It is now time to go into our personal time of prayer, our time with the Lord, our time to share whatever is on our heart. This is our one-on-one time with God to let Him know, you know, whatever is on our heart, to thank Him and to ask for His continuous mercies and faithfulness as we keep planting roots and in order to bear the fruits that He has asked of us. We shall be back shortly.
Praise the Lord. Well, we thank God for this morning again. Thank God for His word. Thank God for answered prayers. Thank God for the privilege to even be able to approach unto Him. You know, the Bible says, blessed is the man whom thou choosest and causes to approach unto you. The privilege. And that's a privilege that is not to be taken lightly. Particularly taking a bearing from the passage this morning. If you go a little bit up before verse 6, from verse 1, I am the vine and ye are the branches. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it to bear more. And that which does not bear fruit, he cast away. You will not be cast away. That in itself, and when you put it together with verse 15 down the line, verse 16, I believe, down the line, that in itself is speaking volumes. Verse 16 said, look, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. The way some Christians do these days, as if they chose God. As if without them, God is finished. As if they are doing God a favor. He said, no. You did not choose me. I chose you, but watch. And I ordained you with a mandate. I gave you a mandate in choosing you. Go and bring forth fruit, he said. And make sure your fruit remain or abide. And then ask me what you will. I've given you what I want you to do. You do what I want you to do, and then ask me what you want. And whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. We didn't choose him. He chose us. We didn't make him. He made us. We didn't set him up. No, he set us up. And here it is finally. We are not going to judge him. He's going to judge us. It's an heavenly mandate. Go forth and bring fruits. That's what I've set you up for. That's what I've ordained you for. That's what I chose you for. And how effective you are, how effective I am, how effective we are, is what is going to judge us on. Remember when talking of the parable of the talents, the one that God more said, Pastor, see, you gave me this, this is what I have more. And the day is coming when he will be asking you, asking me, where are the fruits I ordained you to bear me? Are we going to continue giving him the excuses of our job? You know, God, down there is not easy. If you have been on earth, you will have known that it's not easy. Our job takes so much of my time, my this, my that. That won't fly. You have not chosen him. I have not chosen him. But he chose us with a mandate. And that mandate is go, bring forth fruit. He said that my house may be full, he said. And then ask whatever you will. But we are asking every time. I'm not judging you, but are the fruits that they ask us to bring, are they there? Because he said, and you shall ask after you have brought in the fruit, you shall ask what you will, and it will be granted you. May the Lord give us understanding this morning. Let's do the kingdom bidding everywhere we turn. Souls are waiting, looking for direction, waiting for that person to show them the way. That's why he ordained you. That's why he ordained me. Somebody said, no, Pastor, I'm not ordained. I'm not a pastor. You see, all those ones we talk here are semantics. Jesus ordained you. You just read it. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and I have ordained you, he said. That you should go forth and bring fruit. I ordained you, Jesus said. You are ordained of the Almighty Himself. You are mandated of Him. You are licensed by it. Let's go forward. Keep doing the kingdom bidding, and the King of Kings himself will keep attending to our needs. So you shall ask what you will, and it shall be given unto you. It shall be done for you. You shall ask the Father, and he will give it to you. While we are praying to him, let's keep doing his bidding. Jesus is Lord. We thank God for today. Let's have Sister Lydia close us this morning.
Good morning, family. We thank God for the message today. We thank God for the charge. We are very grateful for the reminders that God gives us. I also would like to remind us as we close today that your giving into this ministry is greatly appreciated. This morning, I would just like to acknowledge everyone who has sown into the ministry of Pastor Tunji and his life, his personal life and his family. And I just want to appreciate you and to bless you. I declare this morning that your seed is going to be prosperous. Everything that you do for God, everything that you do for the men of God, for the children of God, and especially for this ministry, you are doing it specifically to God, and God is blessing your seed abundantly. The book of Zechariah chapter 8 verse 12 says, "The seed shall be prosperous, the vine shall give her fruit, and the ground shall give her increase, and the heavens shall give their due. And I will cause the remnant of this people to possess all these things." So as you continue to give, as you continue to sow into this ministry, I pray that amazing blessing upon you, that your seed, everything that you put into the ground, into good soil, that it will be prosperous, the vines shall produce fruit, that everything that you ask of the Lord, that he will truly reward you abundantly. He is a great, great, he's a great payer. He does not hold back. When he pays beyond your imagination. So we thank God for that. And we ask that you continue to sow into this ministry. As you know, this program runs Monday through Friday. So today being Friday, we'll meet again on Monday and rejoice in the Lord. But for now, as you go, may you be blessed, may your seed increase, and may you be abundantly blessed, and the dew of heaven fall upon you, and the Lord to cause everything that you do to become prosperous. So let us share the goodness. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen.